I think that what's been very disappointing for me is companies like State Farm. They want it both ways, and I think we really need good corporate citizens in a time of a public health crisis to stand up and do the right thing and stand up and say that he did not do the right thing.
Co-host of The View and senior legal analyst for ABC News, Sonny Hostin, has some thoughts.
I'm 48 hours in, and I consulted with a now good friend of mine, Joe Rogan, and I've been doing a lot of the stuff that he recommended in his podcasts.
On unvaccinated Green Bay Packers quarterback Aaron Rodgers.
I'm also disappointed in Aaron Rodgers, of course, for all those reasons, but also to sort of claim that he's being canceled and this use of the word woke.
I realize I'm in the crosshairs of the woke mob right now, so before my final nail gets put in my cancel culture casket, I think I'd like to set the record straight on so many of the blatant lies that are out there.
I think Aaron Rodgers needs to realize that when you look in the dictionary, woke is an adjective meaning that you're alert to racial prejudice and discrimination. And it is something that originated in the African-American community. And he should, using it in that way is despicable and very dismissive to the origin of the term. And he also quoted MLK.
I would, add this to the mix as an aside, but the great MLK said that you have a moral obligation to object to unjust rules and rules that make no sense. In my opinion, it makes no sense for me.
And he quoted Martin Luther King's letter from a Birmingham jail. And I think that's pretty disgusting. And I wonder what the other players that he is supposed to be leading in the position of a quarterback
feel about that. But is he going to continue to be a football player?
Well, of course he is.
Aaron Rodgers isn't going anywhere, at least in terms of his status in the NFL. The Packers? Well, it appears this is his last hoorah, not because of his vaccination status, but because of the mistrust between the quarterback and the front office. Sonny Hostin takes offense in a few areas. First, she believes his usage of the word woke is not accurate, which is true. The true definition has been hijacked by the far right to use as a mockery of left-wing politics. Problem is, it is more about bringing awareness to social justice. As we've seen, MAGAs don't agree with this.
Tonight's episode, the Wokey Pokey.
You can't go woke on a national level.
If we go woke, we're gonna go broke.
The only reason Americans have put up with the endless woke garbage that the left churns out by the gallon.
It's just endless on this side of the aisle. As Fox and others have shown, it is as much to do with the issues of racial and social justice. Criticizing woke culture has become a way of claiming victim status for yourself rather than acknowledging that more deserving others hold that status. It has gone from a virtue signal to a dog whistle. The language has been successfully co-opted. Metro adds, the subversion of woke is political and means the word can now be used to perpetuate the very injustices it sought to eradicate in the first place. The second was Rogers' usage of MLK and putting himself in the same category. As LZ Granderson wrote, the rub is the Green Bay Packers quarterback presented his King paraphrase as if he was on the front lines challenging an unjust law, when in reality, he was just sitting on the couch trying to find ways to avoid being held accountable for his words.
Are you vaccinated and what's your stance on vaccinations?
Yeah, I've been immunized.
An intentional lie. Rodgers purposefully gave a misleading answer because he didn't want any follow-up questions. He tried to be slick, and when the jig was up, played the king card like a rank-and-file member of the conservative corporatism club we thought he didn't want anything to do with. That, out of everything that transpired regarding Rodgers this week, is what I found the most disappointing. In a letter from a Birmingham jail, King wrote, "One has not only a legal but a moral responsibility to obey just laws. Conversely, one has a moral responsibility to disobey unjust laws. I would agree with St. Augustine that an unjust law is no law at all." Donovan Bennett of Sportsnet added of Rodgers comparing himself to MLK's letter from a Birmingham jail is offensive and out of touch. MLK was fighting for equal rights. Rodgers is fighting for privilege. The Root called it the interview's low point, with Rodgers going full-on civil rights martyr, something that's becoming increasingly oddly common among people who refuse to be vaccinated for a virus that's disproportionately killing non-white people and lower-income people, for better or for worse. We are used to seeing folks take King's words out of context to sanitize despicable decisions and policies. President Reagan infamously quoted the civil rights icon while fighting affirmative action, saying we want a colorblind society, a society that, in the words of Dr. King, judges people not by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. It was amusing to watch Reagan and his kind quote that one passage from I Have a Dream, but never any of the points where King spoke in support of reparations or affirmative action. It's worth noting that King wrote his letter from a Birmingham jail in 1963 while he was essentially a political prisoner jailed for leading a nonviolent protest of American apartheid. He was not, in fact, choosing to not play professional football because he refused to get a shot.